Well, good morning to Camp Hope AME Church, located at 114 Camp Hope Church Road, Macon, Georgia, 31211. It is just so good to see all of you out there. Amen. I see out there on the phone line. Amen. I see Sister Betty Strickland. Welcome. Sister Annie Mae Hall. Amen. Welcome. Amen. Sister Annie Waller. Welcome. Reverend Ida Sue Graham. Amen. Brother Curtis Lowe, amen. Brother Henry Lowe, amen. Brother Jerome Collins, welcome, 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 amen. Out there on the virtual line, amen. I see we have Sister Elizabeth Moten, welcome, welcome, welcome. We see Sister Bessie Burns, amen. Welcome, 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 all, one and all. Let's clear our minds this morning and be on one accord, hallelujah. That our God has woke us up this morning, started us on our way, gave us a right mind, amen. That we would come together on one accord, amen. Knowing that if we could come together agreeing spiritually, agreeing mentally, then God will be in our midst. God will dwell among us, not just out in the virtual world, but in our homes, amen. In our lives, wherever we go. So let us agree. Amen. We see, amen. Sister Cornelius, amen, out there. Welcome, 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 welcome. Hallelujah. Let's get right to our announcements. Amen. This morning, amen. Hallelujah. We know that this is that month. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Voting, voting, voting. Hallelujah. So let us get out there and do what we need to do when we vote. Hallelujah.
My sisters and brothers, as we look back through the pages of history, one of the things we will discover is 1787 was a very good year. The African Methodist Episcopal Church was born. 223 years later, I've learned that only a few things never lose their importance. One is voting. Our power is at the voting box. November the 3rd is Election Day. I urge the 12th Episcopal District, home of the Little Rock Nine, to join with the AME Church in the work of the AME V Alert by using the toolkit found at www.amev-alert.org. You will have a step-by-step guide to ensure that your vote counts. Let's get every voter to vote in 2020. I'm Bishop Michael Mitchell, presiding bishop of the 12th Episcopal District, comprising the state of Arkansas and Oklahoma, and also serving as the president of the Council of Bishops, and I approve of this message.
Greetings, praise the Lord. This is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I have a special announcement to bring forth. This is the month of October, and it is Pastors Appreciation Month. This is a time that you will have the opportunity to show your pastor at your church and at Camp Hope how much you appreciate his leadership. Now, Pastor Martin has been a wonderful pastor for the time I have known him. I've been knowing him now since 2016 and here at Camp Hope since 2019. And it's been a wonderful opportunity to serve under him. Thank you, Pastor Michael Martin, for being the wonderful man of God that you are. Please express your love to our pastor or your pastor or our pastor by sharing with him a token of appreciation in an envelope, send it to our church, or email, text messaging. There are so many different ways that you can show your pastor, our pastor, how much you appreciate his leadership. He puts a lot into all the work that he does. Also, even though our churches are closed across the country and we are closed in and locked in because of COVID-19, churches are still up and running when it comes to things that has to be done to make sure that things are kept running for our safe return. Please remember Pastor Appreciation the full month of October and show some love. Have a wonderful rest of your day. Happy Sunday.
A donation through Giveify in the name of the pastor to the church. Amen. For we know that the kingdom needs to keep growing and we need to be supporting our churches doing this time. And we also should always seek ye first the kingdom. I love God. I love the kingdom. And I want to do everything to make sure that the kingdom succeeds. Hallelujah. Let us move forward. Remember us on the prayer line, amen, every Tuesday at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 6 p.m. Central Standard Time, hosted by none other than the Reverend Ida Sue Graham and the Reverend LaTanya Renfro, amen. Come out with them. They are truly prayer warriors, amen. You can join us at 978-990-5041, access code 675-984. Amen. Our prayer list. Amen. If you notice, our prayer list is extensive, but if you don't see, amen, who you want us to keep in our prayers, amen, send us a note, send us a message, type it in, send us a letter, come on the prayer line on Tuesday, let us know. We will add you to our prayer list. We pray and pray, and we know that God says, ask and it shall be given, seek and you shall find, knock and the door shall be opened unto you. And it also says you would always seek out an elder, that the elder might pray for you as well. Amen. Also, we ask that you would follow us on Facebook, amen, at Camp Hope, amen, or MED-Camp Hope AME, amen. You can follow us also on YouTube, amen, and also on Instagram. And also, if you missed any of the services or Bible studies, we have them pre-recorded where you can go back and you can look and revisit them over and over again as many as you times as you will need it. Amen. Also, we want to give you the opportunity if you want to be a virtual member. Amen. You don't have to actually physically be in the church. Amen. We could have members in London, France. We could have members in Alabama. We could have members in Florida, Washington State. If God is moving you to become a part of our family, we invite you to come and be a virtual member to you. Amen. Our God is a great God. So remember, send us a personal message through Facebook, email us at camphopeamc@gmail.com, or write us at 114 Camp Hope Church Road, Macon, Georgia 31211. Amen. Join us out there on our Bible study, amen, on Wednesdays at 6:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, at 5:30, amen, Central Standard Time. Come out, tune in on Facebook or on the phone line as well, which is 978-990-5041, access code 675-984. Also, remember that Day of Thanksgiving is coming and our WMS are gearing up, amen, to give out their baskets, amen. They will be coming starting on October 25th at the church. If you want to bring some items that they may fill up the baskets, they'll be out there from 12 p.m. to 2 p.m., amen, amen. For additional information, amen, you can contact Sister Eddie Mae Hall or Sister Betty Dizar. Eddie Mae Hall can be reached at 478-444-8545 or 478-741-8848. Or you can, again, you can reach Sister Betty Dizar at 478-361-2978. Oh, hallelujah. God is a good God. We just returned back from mid-year conference in Augusta, Georgia, amen, where the 6th Episcopal District, we had a wonderful time, amen. Our presiding elder Alan Wicker, amen, receive a reward, elder of the year, amen. I want you to praise him, let him know that we appreciate him and thank him for all that he does, amen. Again, God is just blessing us and blessing us and blessing us, amen. So let's get right into our praise and worship. Oh, I see Sister Veronica Williams out there. Welcome, welcome. I see Sister Curry has come out with us this morning. Welcome, welcome. Amen, amen, amen. We also see Brenda Stachel. She has joined us on the phone line. Amen. So let us sit back, relax, and enjoy the praise and worship.
Brothers and sisters, I want to welcome you back to life, back to the one that can make your next chapter your best chapter. Hallelujah.
How can it be that you love the most unlovable part of me?
Sister Butler had a birthday. We want to say happy birthday to you, Sister Butler. Amen. Our God has blessed you with another year. We pray that He will give you many, many more years. And happy birthday for all those that have been born in the month of October. Amen. I see Brother Calvin Pitts has joined us. Amen. We welcome you. Welcome you also. I got a last minute announcement that came in. Amen. I see Reverend Thomas. Amen. Good morning. Good morning. Thank you for joining us. All right. Amen. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I want to shoot another announcement in there. The Sixth Episcopal District, Sons of Allen. Amen. It's a Let's Laugh outdoor comedy show. It's going to be Saturday, October 24th, 2020. At 3 o'clock p.m. at the New Greater Allen Temple AME Church in Brandon, Georgia. Amen. This is bring your own lawn chair. Amen. Bring your car. Sit out of your car. Come and enjoy. Amen. Let's laugh together. Amen. Tickets are $25. Amen. Amen. And we'll have more details on that as time goes. We see one of the comedians, his sister, Miss B. Another one is Miss Wall Street. Amen. We see another is Double D is going to be out there. Amen. We see Easy Real is going to be out there. Amen. So we ask you to come and join in. Come out there and let's laugh outdoor comedy show. It's going to be in Bryan, Georgia at the New Greater Allen Temple AME Church. Sponsored by the Women Missionary Society and the Sons of Allen of that church. So let's join in and do that. I see Brother Stan. That's Brother Stan out there. Brother Stan Smith, he shot me that invite. Amen. So let us join together, get our tickets. Let's support our WMS. Amen. And our Sons of Allen. And let's go out there and have a laugh. It's good to laugh. Amen. We have so many other emotions that we be dealing with. Amen. But when you laugh, when you have joy in your heart, it pushes everything else out of the way. So let us join in and let us support them. And grab your tickets and be out there October 25th. Amen. Let's get right into our call to worship. Amen. Join in on our call to worship. Amen. Oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. Come on, say it with me together. But I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem. But the hour is coming, and now is, when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Say it with me, how shall we sing the Lord's song in a foreign land? Do you not know that your bodies are temples of the Holy Spirit who is in you? And though he slay us, yet we will trust him. Come on, say it together with me. Oh, let us sing a new song. For the Lord has done marvelous things. I will sing of loyalty and of justice to you, O Lord. I will sing. And let us listen to our opening hymn. Hallelujah.
He gave his only son, and the son gave his life for me. When he died on Calvary, there's no grace or love. Find it that a man laid down his life for a friend. There's no greater love, no greater love than a man would lay down his life for a friend.
to Calvary to save a wretch, like you and me.
Sins. Amen. I'd like to welcome Sister Palmer. Amen. My sister out there, Sister Melvia Martin. My brother, Brother Mark Hudson. Amen. Brother Drew, welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome. Amen. We see Reverend Tanya Renfro's out there. Amen. Amen. Remember Reverend Renfro, she's also doing her cakes. Amen. Contact her. I tell you, they're good. I've had a chocolate cake from her. I've had a caramel cake from her. And we had some cupcakes. I mean, this young lady, this Reverend, this woman of God know how to make that food talk. So contact her, amen. Also, we want to thank our sponsors, amen. Giving Sis, amen. We want to thank our media crew, amen. We have our president, Deborah Brundage, amen. With her assistant, Sister Brittany Riggins, amen. We just thank all of you all for coming together. We thank all of our sponsors, amen, for helping us, amen. We thank each and every one of you, amen. We see Sister Likes out there, hallelujah. Good to see ya, good to see ya, amen, amen. Brother Drew, amen, from Baton Rouge, all of you out there, we just thank you, thank you, thank you for joining us. But let's go to the throne of God, amen, right now. Lord God, we just thank you. Thank you, God, our Father. Thank you, God, our Mother. Thank you, God, for being our sister, our brother. Thank you, God, for being all that we are for you. We know you are a God that is an uncreated spirit, Lord. We thank you. We thank you for creating us, for being with us, for guiding us. We thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, who came, who thought it not robbery, part of the Godhead, to come here, Lord, and wrap himself in flesh that he might die for our sins. Thank you for giving your only begotten Son. Thank you, Jesus, for sending the Holy Spirit back. For when you left, that we have a comforter, a keeper that will remind us, that will sustain us, to let us know that we are never alone in the name of Jesus. Lord, if we had 10,000 tongues, Lord, we could not praise you enough. Hallelujah, Lord. We wake up saying thank you. We go to bed saying thank you. Oh, I know when I'm dreaming, I'm saying thank you as well, Lord. We just thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord. Thank you for keeping us during this time and in this season, Lord. Thank you that there are good in everything, no matter how bad it is. Good things can come out of it because we know that all things work together for our good, Lord. Thank you for protecting us from the weapons, for they truly form, but they are not prospering, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for lifting us up. Thank you for giving us peace. Thank you for giving us joy. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord, for protecting us even from ourselves, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for giving us a way to worship, letting us know that the building has nothing to do with it, Lord, that we are your temples and we can come together and worship in spirit and in truth. And we just thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And oh, Lord, forgive us for our sins that we have done in thought, in word, and deed, Lord. And Lord, we pray for each person that's out on our prayer list, Lord. Touch right now in the name of Jesus. Touch their situation, touch their circumstances, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We pray for those that didn't get on our prayer list and are watching us, or some of their representatives are watching us. Lord, we pray for them, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. We pray for my first cousin, Derek Cole, as he has lost his wife, Lord. We pray for him that you would give him strength, Lord, as he moved forward to do those things that you would have him to do, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray for those that are out there worshiping in the parking lots of their churches, Lord. We pray for those that decided to go back in their buildings, Lord. We pray for all in all. We pray for our bishops. We pray for our presiding elders, Lord. We pray for each one of our members, our pastors, Lord. We pray for them all, Lord. Let us all come together, one in agreement, that you might be in the midst of all of our worship and all of our praise and all of our gatherings, no matter what we're doing or how we are doing it, as long as we're lifting you up, Lord, be in our presence in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we'll be careful to give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. This is our prayer we pray in Jesus' name. And Holy Spirit, there's some that I have not prayed. We ask you to lift it up to the throne of grace and mercy. Bless me, that I might represent you well, that I might glorify you, Lord. Perfect my gifts, Lord. Not for me, but that I might glorify you, that I might be a true witness. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. And thank God. Come on, say amen with us this morning. I see Sister Hall has joined us as well. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Come on, let's go right to our scripture reading. Amen. Amen. Our scripture reading will come from John chapter 15, verses 1 through 8. John chapter 15, verses 1 through 8. If you don't have your swords, get your swords out. If you don't have them near, of course, bring it up on your phone. Amen. If not that, you could follow us on our screen. John chapter 15, verses 1 through 8. It says, I am the true vine, and my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit, while every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes so that it will be even more fruitful. You are already clean because of the word I have spoken to you. Remain in me as I also remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me. I am the vine. You are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. If you do not remain in me, you are like a branch that is thrown away and withers. Such branches are picked up, thrown into the fire, and burned. If you remain in me and my word remain in you, ask whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. This is to my Father's glory, that you bear much fruit, showing yourself to be my disciples. I've read to you John chapter 15, verses 1 through 8. Let us sing in a cappella, amen, from all that dwells. from all that dwells below the sky, let thy Creator's praise arise. Let the Redeemer's name be sung through every land by every tongue. The summary of the Decalogue, hear what Christ our Savior said, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Let us sing, glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. It's time to show our obedience unto God, because God asked the question, will a person rob God? And we will say no, but God says we will. So we ask the question, how, Lord, are we robbing you? And he says, in tithes and offering. Amen. Remember that God asked us to tithe. Amen. Tithe because he woke us up this morning. Tithe because he started us on our way. Tithe because God is with us. Amen. So let us give in our tithes and offer. We know this is the season and the time where it is a little different to us, or our churches are operating under the gifts that we receive virtually, Lord. Amen. So you can give through Giblify. Amen. You can mail it to us. Amen. At 114 Camp Hope Church Road, Macon, Georgia, 31211. Amen. So give. Amen. We just thank our sponsors. Amen. That they have been giving. We thank our members that have been giving unto us. Amen. We just thank you, thank you, thank you so much for all that you do to support us, to keep us going, because we cannot do it without you. Amen. And remember, for all of our sponsors, all of our partners out there, amen, we thank you for all that you give to us. But remember, amen, if you're a member of another church, amen, make sure you send your tithes and offerings there. Amen. Send them. Amen. That's how we're operating. That's how we're doing. Amen. Everything you give above and beyond your tithes, amen, that's where we find our blessing. And we thank you. No gift is too small. Amen. We thank all of you for also joining in with our mortgage. Amen. Which we will be celebrating here soon. Amen. We are still receiving. Amen. Our pastor's team has grown a little bit more. We have raised $7,265. The justice team has raised $2,425. The harmony team, $2,747. And the aid team, $9,100. Amen. So let us help out, amen, those teams as they go forward to do what they do to meet their goals. Amen. We ask you to support the justice team, the harmony team, as they do what they need to do to reach their goal. And remember, we're going to have our mask and our shirt and our celebration, for God has blessed us as we go forward. Amen. Amen. Remember, if you have not received your shirt, if you have not received your mask, amen, get with that team leader, amen, to say, I have not received my shirt, I have not received my mask. We will get them out there to you. Amen. How did we get the shirt and the mask? If you go over $50 over what we have asked, you get a mask. If you go over $100 over what we've been asked, you get a shirt. Amen. You get both. Amen. We just thank you, thank you, thank you as we do what we do. All right, enough of that. I'm ready for the word. Are you ready for the word? Here we got a special today. We know none other than our own Reverend Ida Sue Graham bringing the word to us today. Hallelujah. God has spoken to her, amen, to do what it is you need to do that you might be enriched. So let us hear our sermonic selection before the sermon.
Thank you. Before I spoke a word, you were singing over me. You have been so, so good to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You have been so, so kind to me. Still your love fought for me. You have been so, so good to me. When I felt no worth, you paid it all for me. You have been so, so kind. Kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. No shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, now you won't tear down, coming after me.
tuning in this morning, and thank you, Pastor, for this opportunity to come forth one more time, for no day is promised to us, and I thank you for this honor to be able to sit here one more time to bring forth the word. Thank you also for reading the word this morning, which is the book of John, chapter 15, verses 1 through 8. Let's pray. We're going to hurry up and get on out your way this morning. Thank you so much for the sunshine, the rain, whatever the weather is in the area where you are. We love you. We adore you. We thank you, Father, Mother God, for just giving me air in my lungs this morning. Thank you. Let forth the word come this morning. We pierce someone's heart, massage it, so they know that you are real and you live. Thank you, thank you, thank you. For I do not take this for granted, this opportunity to breathe air on this day. Remove Ida Sue out the way, and please come forth with this word for your people. Amen, amen, amen. Well, thank you again. I'll be coming to you from the book of John 15, chapter 15. If I was to name this sermon, it would be No Greater Love. Now, that was a couple that was driving through the Rocky Mountains when a truck ran them off the road. And the car went into the Colorado River. The couple, they scrunched very hard to get out of the vehicle. And when they got out, the rapid waters was so strong in the current, they were not able to swim toward the shore. But there was another truck that was driving that saw what had happened, them being forced off the road. And he was able to run down to the shore and throw a rope into the water toward them. The husband managed to swim to the rope and bring it and give it to his wife as he made sure she was secure on the rope. He was not able to hold on because he had used all of his strength. It took to fight the currents to get to her. The husband, he pushed his wife to the rope for her safety, his love. She survived. He didn't. The currents of the Colorado River carried the husband on down the river's water. He did not survive. He gave his life to save his love, his wife, the woman that he loved. He gave his life so another could live. That is the ultimate sacrifice. The ultimate love is proof that you love someone. Didn't the Lord do that in John 3:16? For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son. He gave his son for us so that we could live. His son took on all the sins of us, of me, of you, everyone, of our children, everyone. He took those sins on. Now, in this book of John, chapter 15, it talks about the vine and the branches. Now, Jesus Christ is the vine, and God is the gardener. The branches and the true believers who are living union with Christ and to produce much fruit. It's important we produce fruit so that we can grow and tell others on how they can turn their life to Jesus Christ. Now, anyone who turns away from Christ after he gives a commitment that he loves the Lord and he's going to serve the Lord, that's really on them. For they're going to be separated from the vine and be cut off, pruned away, and placed in a pile that's no longer good. Now, there are two types of pruning. The first pruning is cutting back. That also promotes the growth for fruit branches to grow. The second one is separate, which means cut off. That means completely cut off. You're not going in cutting just a little bit. You're cutting the whole piece off. Are you prunable? Are you worth being saved by God? Can you bear fruit? Galatians 5:22 and verses 22 to 24, we'll talk a little bit more about that. That means, are you a Christian? Are you being a Christian? Do you have Christian character? It talks about that also in 2 Peter chapter 1, verses 5 through 8. No greater love. Now, look at verse 5 of chapter 15, and let's read that together. Chapter 15, verse 5. I am the vine, and you are the branches. If you remain in me, and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. That is something. This is Jesus' words. And that when you get time after the service, please read the rest of 15. It's Jesus talking through the whole chapter. All those red words is Jesus talking. So that's awesome. Now, people do try to do good. They try very hard to do good. But it's doing good enough. The only way to do right is to stay close to him. Stay close to Jesus. Think of the vine of the grapes. How they run up and twist into each other. They bear fruit. But they can't bear fruit without Jesus. Jesus' love must be present. We are fruitless and we will dry up if we cannot bear the fruit of the pile. And that pile of dry veins goes into a fire. Are you being nourished by the life of Christ, the vine? Are you missing the gift from God? Remaining in Christ means believing that Jesus is the Son of God. 1 John chapter 4, verse 15. It means that you receive Jesus as your Savior, your personal Savior and Lord. John chapter 1, verse 12. Do what God says. 1 John chapter 3, verse 24. And believe the gospel. 1 John chapter 2, verse 24. Now in verse 8, it says, God is glorified when a vine bears fruit. Can you imagine heaven just rejoicing and sending down the rain and then giving you sunshine to shine all over you because you have been multiplied after you have been pruned back and your growth is just visible for all to see? The sunshine comes to promote the vine and gives it new growth. The harvest is glorified when God's people are in a relationship with him. And that's what we thrive to do, is be in relationship with Jesus Christ by studying our word, attending a service on YouTube, on Facebook, online, talking to someone on the phone about the Bible study that you just heard last week and getting a better understanding of it. And the fruit that's in your life is never going to be too much because you're going to be able to share it with someone else. The relationship with him and the fruit in your life can be much. It can be so full that your basket is just going to be overran. Like back in the day when we picked those berries, not only were we able to make one pie, but we're still making a pie. We had enough to make a cobbler and make a small pie to give to the lady next door. Yes, we want our fruit to grow and be multiplied. That means we want our word from God to grow so we can have a conversation with another believer of the word of Jesus Christ. Now, Jesus says in verse 9 that he loved us just as he loved his father. His father loved him and he loved us the way his father loved him. Now, that is love. All we have to do is keep his commandments and keep his commands and remain in his love. He tells us in his word that our joy will be complete. Can you imagine have completed joy and continue to have good health, Continue to see the wonderful sunshine outside and not deal with so much chaos in our life. Because right now, there's a lot of chaos going on. We see it in everything. We open up the newspaper. I love to read the newspaper. We see it when we turn on the TV and listen to the radio. And we see all kinds of stuff going bad. COVID is on the rise. Government is not going well. We just found out the stimulus that was supposed to be coming. Once again, number 45 has decided it's not going to happen until he's reelected. We have a lot to be concerned about, but we have a lot to pray about so that the love of Christ will continue to grow in us and keep that anger and hatred out of our spirit. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life than one's friend. You are my friend if you do what I commanded. So, since you have been chosen to do, go and bear fruit. You are chosen by God, by Jesus, to have greater love. So ask in Jesus' name, and the Father will give you love, and you are to love each other. This world will give you a whole lot, but it cannot give you the love of Jesus Christ. There are a lot of Christians right now that has a lot of hatred, and we do not want to become one of them. We are to do as we are commanded. We are to love one another and put away that hate. We are to love one another as Jesus has loved us. Jesus will give you, he will give us the strength that we need to make it through each hour of the day. Love from Jesus is priceless. Love from Jesus to you is all that you need. There is no greater love than the love from our Lord. Just like the woman who was given her life again by her husband, and she was spared from the Colorado River, so you too can be saved if you just stay anchored and hold on to that rope that will pull you closer into the bosom of God. Love one another. There is no greater love than the love of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
No greater love. Our God is a good God, and his mercy for us endures forever and ever and ever. Are you bearing fruit? Are you connected to the vine? Have you accepted Jesus as your Lord and your Savior? Scripture says, without being connected to the vine, you cannot bear fruit. It says you'll dry up. You'll be tossed into the fire to be burned. Let us listen to our hymn of invitation. Praise God.
How can this love reach through all my shame? Pull me from the grave and bring me back to life again. How can this grace cover all my sin? Pick me up and put my feet on solid ground again. Jesus, everything and more. You're everything and more.
Everything and more.
Jesus,
you're everything and more.
You're everything and more. There is no love than the love from the God we serve. There is no greater love than the love from the God we serve. There is no greater love than the love from the God we serve. There is no greater love than the love from the God we serve. How can this love
Send us an email, send us a note, amen. Remember, the doors of the kingdom are open. Come and join in with us. Those of you that would like to be virtual members, this is your opportunity as well to become a virtual member, be connected with our part of the kingdom, amen. Come and join us, amen, hallelujah. We will be soon coming in with what we call out for prayer, those that may need prayer, amen. We'll have a phone line, we'll have a sector where we can let you come and pray with others. Amen. We are getting ready for when Jesus come back, that God will say, good and faithful servant. Amen. This is your opportunity. This is your time. This is your problem. All you have to do is confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God sent Jesus and Jesus died for our sins. He rose from the dead and he is our Lord and Savior. If you've accepted us, let us know. If you've accepted Jesus, let us know. If you want to come apart, let us know, is our prayer. Amen. I've enjoyed today's service. I pray that you have enjoyed today's service. Amen. We just thank you all for tuning in. We see Reverend Mills is joining us. Amen. Reverend Lawson has joined us. Amen. We saw Brother Neely came and joined us as well. We thank you. Thank you for tuning in with us. Remember, tune back in on Wednesdays. Amen. We've been out in conference. We'll be back on Wednesday at 6:30. Amen. We will be bringing a word from the Lord from none other than myself on Sunday. Amen. At 9:30 this coming Sunday. Amen. Come join out with us. Come out on the prayer lines on Tuesdays. Amen. Let us do what we need to do again. Thank you to our sponsors. Thank you for our faithful members. Thank you for those that have joined in with us and prayed with us, that has given us a donation that we could move forward and do what we do. We cannot do it without you. Amen. We thank you. So let us join in with our Apostle Creed. Amen. Let us say it together. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he arose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From this it shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Church Universal, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of body, and life everlasting. Amen. Thank you again for joining in with us. God bless you. Tune in next time. Come grow with us here as we transform our minds to think the way Christ has told us to think. God loves you, and I love you with the love of Christ. Tune in next time.